fact that grappling can be stalled in USA for quite a while, so Americans have been doing so well. But also, it's just a fact that it's just cheaper to install. The reality is it. It's just cheaper to install in an educational system, for example. To be short and short, whether you like it or not, it is extremely popular for the base of wrestling as it is. I'm a fan of wrestling. I keep telling the guys, and as much as a purist, my background since I moved to the United States has been developing MMA fighters for quite a while. So I dedicate myself a lot to try to learn as wrestling as much as I can. The grappling will be also as a striking for MMA. So a couple of things that's very basic to start on it. And it's funny because, for example, the stance are so different. We go for a judo stance. In a judo stance, you have the dominant hands and the right hand. You hold it from here. While your goal for striking is the opposite. In wrestling, when you go to stance, for me, for example, it's easier to shoot a single leg, a double leg, with the back leg being my dominant foot, my dominant leg, from here. And we see this a lot in the evolution of grappling MMA because the guys are very good at hip throws from here, but in the time to go for a strike and they switch, or time to go for a single leg, double leg, they switch again. I'm bringing all this, and like it or not, Jiu-Jitsu and MMA are connected to, they're the same soul together. Now, for grappling itself, we suffer here. We gotta go a little bit up on a couple of other things that are important. Number one is, the stance of wrestling, they're a little bit lower, which is in grappling, it's not always like this, because the fundamental guys in Jiu-Jitsu, they do a lot of what they eat judo throughout, so the stance is a little bit high. But also, when you put down too much, there's a big chance for you to get the step down to go for a guillotine. That's a lot. So it started from a very basic position, from a collar tie or neck tie from here. You want to get your hands inside. Change the level in, right? This is important because as much as she comes in, if I got my hand inside and control it, I can change my level down. Single, double, gonna go from there. And I like to go from here, guys, because from this position, especially if they're too low, to snap down, switching from here to here. We start doing a lot of variations for guillotines, arse chokes, and so far so on, and spinning to the back. So I'm gonna just try to go over very easy to warm up everybody. Doesn't need to go too hard. Collar tie, she's gonna grab the collar tie. Head inside, I drop my level down, my shot, my wrestling shot here, and go to go the high crotch. That's this hand in. Don't let this hand go deep in the underhook, because this is always going to be a problem for it. Got from here. Step. Double that. Then we evolve from there for a grappling perspective. Got it? One more time. Do it one more time. Collar tie. I find my hand inside. Open the elbow. High crotch. Step. Cut the corner for a single to double. 1, 2, 3.